So let's see today's agenda. What is Python? Why it is called as scripting language? Differences between scripting and programming languages? Features of Python? What can you do with Python? Who uses Python? And last, your challenges. What is Python? It is a scripting language developed by Guido van Rossum in 1989. So why it is called as scripting language means it is an interpreted Bayesian language. Let's see what is the main difference between scripting language and programming language. Actually, scripting is nothing but programming. In the scripting also, we are using all procedural concepts as well as what? Object-oriented concepts. But still, we are calling as what? Scripting. We are not calling as what? Programming languages. So, let's see what is the main difference. Scripting languages are interpreted Bayesian languages. Programming languages are compiler Bayesian languages. Actually, interpreter and compilers are the softwares to translate high-level instructions into machine language. Both softwares are used for to convert high-level instructions into machine language. But interpreted Bayesian languages converts high-level instructions into machine language line by line. So what is meant by line means? See, suppose this is my program. So whenever you execute any interpreted based application, directly the program going for execution. Whenever you run any interpreted based application, directly the program going for execution. That means first line checks what? Syntax error. In the first line, no syntax error. Translates into machine language. Executes first line. Displays what? First line output on the screen. Then second line checks what? Syntax error. No syntax error in the second line. Converts into machine language. Executes. Displays second line output on the screen. Third line. In the third line, if it finds some syntax error, okay, it stops what? Execution. It displays what? Syntax error. Then we have to open the program. We have to check and we have to correct. Again, if you execute, again it checks in the first line syntax error. No error. Translates. Execute. Shows first line output. Second line. No error. Translates. Execute. Shows output. Third line. No error. Translates. Execute. Shows output. So it executes what? Line by line. But in case of programming languages, suppose if you take any programming language, so whenever you execute any programming language, first it is not going for execution. First it is going for compilation. Compilation means it checks in entire program syntax errors. If length code of the program is 100 lines or 1000 lines or 10,000 lines, entire program it checks what? All syntax errors. Wherever it finds syntax errors, it lists out all syntax errors. Then we have to check all the syntax error and we have to correct. Again, if you execute, again it is not going for what? Execution. Again, it is not going for what? Execution. Again, it is going for what? Compilation. Checks what? Syntax errors. If no syntax errors, if it is compiled program successfully without syntax errors, then whole program in one shot it converts into machine language and executes whole program, displays the entire program output on the screen. So right, So interpreter executes what? Line by line. But compiler means first it is not going for execution. Entire program checks syntax errors. There are no any syntax error in entire program. Then it converts the whole program into machine language, executes and shows the output. Next. Interpreted Basic Languages doesn't create .exe file. But compiler Basic Languages creates what? .exe file. And interpreter means open any text editor, write the script and execute the script. No need to compile. Open editor, write the script, directly execute. But compiler means what? Open the editor, write the program. After writing the program, you have to compile the program. Once program compiled successfully, then it links with library files, finally creates what? .exe file. But scripting means no need to compile. But programming always takes what? Compilation. And scripting languages takes less lines of code. But programming languages takes many lines of code. In the scripting, if you are writing one or two lines of code, means the same code, the same task, if you want to achieve in programming languages, you have to write 10 to 30 lines of code you have to develop. That means the programming languages takes a lot of time to develop the application, increases development time, increases cost of maintenance. So let me explain this concept with simple example. How it takes less lines, how it takes many lines of code. Let's see. Write a program to display Hello Python text 10 times on screen. Write a program to display Hello Python text 10 times on screen. So I want to show Hello Python text 10 times on screen. Let's see how to develop this task by using C language. So in C means first you have to start header files, then you have to start main, you have to declare the variable, you have to initialize the variable, then you have to start the loop, print Hello Python. Okay, so then you have to increment what? Variable. Then you have to write return statement, you have to close. So here how many lines of code we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 lines of code. If you run this 13 lines of code, what is the output you can see on the screen? Hello Python 10 times on screen. So to write this 13 lines of code, at least you have to try in what? 2 weeks of what? C course. By attending first class, second class, third class, you cannot develop this task by using what? C language. At minimum, you have to try in 2 weeks. You have to understand what is header file, why we have to start with main, what is the difference between int main and void main, what is int, what is CLRSCR, so what is while loop, what is printf, what is plus plus, what is return. Like this, you have to understand many things and you have to build the logic. Right? Let's see the same task how to do in our Python scripting. See, print. Print is a normal English word. Anyone can understand what is print. Print means it prints. What I want to print? Hello Python. So print Hello Python. How many times it prints? One time. But how many times here I want to print? 10 times. Into 10. So into numeric multiplication. So it multiplies this string 10 times on screen. It multiplies this string 10 times. So it displays Hello Python 10 times on screen. It displays that Hello Python 10 times on screen. This is Python interactive mode. See, print Hello Python slash n into 10. So how many times it printed? 10 times. So here itself you got the point. Into anybody can understand multiplication operator. You know how to multiply numbers? The same way we can multiply what? Strings. See how it's simple. Hello, again, is it breaking? No, can you hear me? Audible. Okay. Wait a minute.
Hello.
Yeah, we are
able to hear you, but in between, your voice is not audible.
Okay. I don't know why it's happening like this. Yeah, one minute. Hello, now can you hear me? Now is it okay?
Yeah, it's okay now.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So let's see the same task in Perl scripting. So in Perl scripting also, print is a keyword. Okay, to print the given text, print hello Python. It prints one time, but I want to display 10 times. In Perl scripting, to multiply strings, the operator is x. X alphabet small x. In Perl scripting, to do numeric multiplication into. Okay, but to do string multiplication x. So it multiplies the given string specified number of times. But in our Python scripting, in Python, if you write like this, 10 into 3, so it displays what? 30. So 10 is a number, automatically Python performs numeric multiplication. If you write 10 into 3, now 10 is string, so automatically Python performs string multiplication. But in Perl scripting, you should be very careful. So while doing numeric multiplication, you have to use what? Into operator. To do string multiplication, you have to use what? Alphabet X. Right? The same task, if you want to do in shell scripting, in Unix or Linux, S is a Unix command. It displays the given text infinite times. Yes, S means always S. S means always true. There is no termination. But I won't show 10 times only. Then redirect to head command. Head minus 10. So it displays exactly 10 times on screen. See, if you take either Python scripting or Perl scripting or shell scripting, just one line of code. But the same task either in C or CPP or Java or .NET, you have to write some 10 to 15 lines of code. That means script and scripting is what? Very, very easy to learn. Now here itself you got the point. What is into, what is X. But here if you know C, then only you can understand all these steps. If you don't know C, you can't understand any one of the step also. So that means script. Scripting languages very, very easy to learn compared to any programming language. Easy to learn, easy to develop, takes less time, reduces cost of maintenance. Then why we have to go for programming languages? Here so many advantages. Easy to learn, easy to develop, takes less time, reduces cost of maintenance. Then why we have to go for programming languages? How to develop good client-based applications with very, very good business logics and rich user-friendly interfaces means by using what? Programming languages. How to develop good business-oriented applications with very good business logics and rich user-friendly interfaces means by using what? Programming languages. Once the applications are developed by using programming languages, every application at background, okay, every application at server side, day to day, we have to perform n number of tasks. The application may be web application or a desktop application, GUI application, ETL application, reporting application, or a ERP application, or you are in middleware technologies, or a data science side, or machine learning side, whatever your technology, in the background, day to day, we have to perform n number of tasks. So instead of doing those tasks manually, one time write what? Script and schedule what? Script. What date, what time the script scheduled. According to that date, that time, the script itself executes and completes what? Given task. The most of the scripting languages, mainly where we are using means to automate what? Day-to-day tasks. Whatever tasks repeatedly you want to do, like daily basis, weekly twice, weekly thrice, monthly once, monthly twice, quarterly once. Instead of doing manually, one time write the script and schedule it. It saves a lot of work time. We can reduce manpower. We can reduce cost of maintenance. We can avoid human mistakes. So what are the tasks we have to perform day to day? We have to do system health checkups. We have to take backups. We have to monitor n number of files. Based on data in the files, we have to take decisions and we have to do further tasks. We have to generate reports. We have to analyze what? Huge data. We have to analyze what? Huge data. And at a time, we have to start what? Hundreds of servers. Every day I want to start hundreds of servers in the morning 8 a.m. and every day evening 5 p.m. I want to stop the servers, or I want to clean the disk space. I want to remove temporary files. I want to transfer files from one location to another location. Okay, or I want to start a number of database instances. So I want to do monitor log files. Okay, so like all these tasks, instead of doing manually, we can write what? Scripts, and we can schedule what? Scripts. Let's see one simple example of automation. What is meant by automation? Now, let us take backup. So everyone knows what is meant by backup. Suppose I want to take backup every day in the morning 2 a.m. So this is daily basis backup. This is daily basis backup, and every day I want to take backup at 2 a.m. So to take this backup, nearly I have to run 7 steps. How many steps I want to run to take this backup? 7 steps I have to run. So here I executed first step. So the first request, the first command taking 5 minutes time. How much time the command require, how much time it needs to complete that request means 5 minutes. So I have to wait 5 minutes. Then execute that second command. Okay, the second command needs some 10 minutes time. So I have to wait 10 minutes. Then execute that third command. Actually, backup is nothing but what? Copy. Copy source file system, target file system. Right? Okay, backup is nothing but what? Copy source file system, and you have to specify what? Target file system. So depend on the source file system size, it may take 1 hour time, 2 hours time, 3 hours time also. Assume here it needs 2 hours time. How much time does it require to complete this request? 2 hours. So I have to wait 2 hours. I have to wait what? 2 hours. Meanwhile, not possible to do some other tasks also because I want to monitor how to observe. Due to any reason, if this command fails, if the command raises error, then as a administrator, I have to check that error, I have to solve that error, right? So nearly taking what? 2 hours. If any error occurs, as a administrator, I have to solve that error and I have to continue the backup. So then I executed what? Fourth command, then fifth command, then sixth command, then seventh command. So nearly it is taking 3 hours time. Every day I want to spend that time 2 a.m. to 5 a.m. Okay, every day I want to spend time 2 a.m. to 5 a.m. to take only this backup. And every day I have to run the same commands only. Every day I have to run what? Same commands. So instead of doing manually, okay, what steps you are running manually, put all those steps into one text file. The text file called as one script. What you are doing manually, okay, those steps only we have to write in one text file. The text file called as what? Script. So here how many steps are required to take the backup? 7 steps. But once you decided to automate the task, not only these 7 steps, for these 7 steps, you have to add few more steps also. Manually means 7 steps only. In that, no doubt. Manually means 7 steps only. But once you decided to automate, you have to add few more steps. What are those few more steps? See, you are doing manually. If this copy command raises error, then you are solving that error. But once you decide to automate the task, the script responsibility to solve that error also. Right? So that error solutions also we have to write in the script. So we have to capture the errors. Now, source file, target file. So now this is a given error file. If this command executed successfully and this file is empty, if this command failed, immediately it writes those errors into this file. Now, in the next step, I want to check whether this command executed successfully or not. If some variable, then see. If this command executed successfully, this variable returns true. If this command failed, then this variable returns false. This variable holds last command status. If last command executed successfully, this variable returns true. If last command failed, this variable returns false. Executed successfully, then run that 4 steps. If that command executed successfully, run what? That 4 steps, remaining 4 steps. Suppose if this command failed, then else. So if this command failed, where it writes those errors? Error file. Then you have to open in the else part error file. Then you have to read the error. Okay, you have to open what? Error file. Then you have to read data from error file. If error double equal to a error. Okay, you have to write one solution. Else if error equal to b error, you have to write b error solution. Else if error okay is equal to c error, okay, you have to write the solution. Now this is called as what? Automation. Wherever chances are there to occur errors, for every error even yourself you have to write what? Solution. Now save this script. Now suppose I save this script with database backup.py. So every day sharp at what time I want to run this script? 2 a.m. Instead of running manually, you can schedule the script. If it is Unix platform, is the scheduler command is crontab. By using crontab utility, we can schedule what? Script. So now you can forget about the job. Now you can forget about this job. Your server time is 2 a.m. The crontab itself executes what? This script. The script itself takes what? Backup. So meanwhile, I can do what? Some other tasks. So we can reduce what? Manpower. So we can reduce what? Cost of maintenance. And we can avoid what? Human mistakes also. See, it is routine job. Routine job also, if you are doing manually, means there are n number of chances are there to do what? Some mistakes. Suppose if I given a different target location. Now the entire data copied into different location. So after 2 hours, if I realize that, again I have to start from beginning. Again I have to spend what? 2 more hours time. Routine job also, as a humans, we can do what? Some mistakes. How to avoid these human mistakes and how to reduce the cost of maintenance, how to reduce manpower and how to complete on time means by automating the tasks. For that reason, most of the companies, they are looking for what? Automation. And nowadays, we have to work with what? Huge, huge data. After the social networks, e-commerce cloud technologies, every day we have to work with huge data. And we have to work with hundreds of servers and all. So manually means takes a lot of time and need more manpower and it is not possible to complete on time. Then how to overcome all these problems means by automating the tasks. For that reason, the Python got what? More boom in the market. So got it? What is meant by automation? Otherwise, one more simple example, even in our real life, in our routine life, so many things we are automating. Our routine life, so many things we are automating. So best example, your home appliances. Best example, your home appliances. Let us take rice cooker. See, without rice cooker also, we can make what? Without rice cooker also, we can make what? Rice. So without rice cooker, if you want make rice means at least you have to spend what? 20 minutes time. At least you have to spend what? 20 minutes time and you have to observe. Right? So every day we have to cook the rice. It is not possible to skip any one of the day also. Every day we have to cook. And every day we have to spend what? 20 minutes time. Morning we have to cook and again evening also we have to cook. So 20 plus 20 is what? 40 minutes time you have to spend. If it is routine job also, we can do some mistakes. Suppose if you forget to turn off the gas, then rice burns. So once rice burns, again you have to cook or not? That means again you have to spend 20 more minutes time. Routine job only, but we can do mistakes. Okay, but if you take rice cooker, just you have to spend what? 2 minutes time. Pour the rice, set the time, just switch on, lock the door and go. Over. So without rice cooker 20 minutes, with rice cooker 2 minutes. See, old generation people, they never use rice cookers like roti makers, okay, or mixers or washing machines, anything. But nowadays everyone using, because nowadays whoever staying in the home, everyone is busy. We don't have that time. For that reason, we are depending on what? These electrical items. These are all automation tools only, whatever you are using in your home. Why we are depending on these automation tools means because we don't have that time. And if it is one time job, no need to buy rice cooker, wastage of money. It is routine job. So we are using what? This. Right? The same way the IT industry is, whatever tasks, whatever your technology, whatever tasks you want to do repeatedly. So instead of doing manually, how to automate? By writing the scripts. That is the main concept of what? Scripting languages. But remember guys, Python scripting not only for automation, using Python, even we can develop what? Applications also. Python we can use in two ways. Completely we can use Python for what? Automation. Or completely we can use Python for what? Development also. That I will discuss. Okay, now you got these points. What are the differences between scripting and programming? And what is meant by automation? Right? Now, let's see. The next is the important features of Python. Why the companies are moving into Python? Now at current IT market, if you go for any job at current trend, if you go for any job, every company expecting additional skill as what scripting languages. Most of the job profiles you can see like this: Shell, Python, Perl. Most of the technologies. Okay, Shell, Python, Perl. So if you are not showing the scripting language in your resume, okay, even they won't consider your resume also. At least if you present the scripting languages on your resume, at least you will get call from the companies. So why most of the companies are going for Python scripting? Okay, now let's see. So see, very important feature is Python is simple and very, very easy to learn. Okay, one of the great feature of Python scripting is it is very simple, very easy to learn. To be honest, to learn Python scripting doesn't require any prerequisite. Okay, Python itself called as what? Beginner's programming language. To learn Python doesn't require any prerequisite. Python itself called as what? Beginner's programming language. Right? So very simple, very easy to learn. It is not like C++, Java. In Java, you are writing 100 lines of code, means in Python, you can develop within 20 lines of code. Java takes 1 hour time, means here you can complete within 10 minutes. They require 10 programmers, means here within with a 3 to 4 programmers, you can complete the task. So many ways Python is very, very simple, very, very easy to learn. Even I taught Python scripting for 3 7th class kids. You believe or not, 3 7th class kids, they came and they learned Python from me. Last month only, one 7th class kid, she is staying in Singapore. I took online for her. Why she learned means to develop what? Games. She is very much interested to develop what? Games. For that reason, she learned Python from me. So that much simple, simple and very easy to learn. Okay, it's not like C++, Java. That is one of very important feature of Python. And second is, it is completely free software and it is open source software. No need to take the license. Okay, completely free software. And it is what? Open source software. The source code readily available in the market. If you want, you can download, you can do what? Changes also. And if you have any flavor of Unix, like Linux, Sun Solaris, IBM X, HP Unix, or any flavor of Linux, like Red Hat, Fedora, Ubuntu, OpenSUSE, CentOS, Oracle Enterprise Linux, all these flavors of Unix and Linux, Python interpreter is what? Inbuilt. Even in your Unix machines, Linux machines, no need to install Python software. If you have Unix machine, Linux machine, directly you can write Python scripts, you can execute. If you want the latest version, means you have to upgrade the software. But by default, you can see Python interpreter in either Unix or Linux. And it is completely object-oriented scripting language. Python is 100% object-oriented scripting language, just like Java. In Python scripting, everything called as what? Object. See, x is equal to hello world. This is my variable. So x is a string variable. Now if I write x dot count of l, so it counts l character, how many times repeated in the string. So how many times l character repeated? 3 times. The count is what? 3. See, x dot count, so x acts as string object. X dot count, count is a method of what? String object. In Python scripting, every variable itself acts as object. So it is 100% object oriented scripting language. Suppose all OOPS concepts like encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, data abstraction, exception handling, multi-threading, everything. And it is highly portable scripting language. What is meant by portable? easy to carry. The Python scripts developed in one operating system allows to run in another operating system with or without modifications. Today I created Python scripts on Windows operating system. As it is, those scripts I can copy into Unix box, I can execute, or I can copy into Linux box, I can execute, or I can copy into Mac, I can execute. So highly portable, nearly it supports 80 plus operating systems. And one more very important feature of Python is it has very rich set of libraries, are also called as what? Modules, are also called as what? Packages. Python is very, very, very rich in its modules and libraries. Okay, you can say module, or you can say library, or you can say APIs, or you can say package. The collection of modules is what? Package. How many modules are available in Python scripting means 1 lakh plus modules. Just imagine. Not thousands of modules. 1 lakh plus modules are available. For that reason, we can use Python any field in the IT as well as non-IT industries. One point, understand, Python is not designed for specific purpose in the IT industry. It is not designed for specific purpose. Whatever your field in the IT market, additionally, you can use Python scripting. Whatever your field in the IT market, additionally, you can use what? Python scripting. Whether you are a system administrator, either Windows administrator or Unix administrator or Linux administrator or database administrator or network administrator, or you are on WebLogic side, WebSphere side, Hadoop side, data science side, machine learning side, DevOps side, AWS side, finance side, telecom side, cloud technologies side, ERP side, ETL side, reporting side, or embedded system side, VLSI design side, robotic engineering side, image processing side, GIS arc side, animation, 2D, 3D animation side, we can use what? Python scripting. And you can use Python for what? Development purpose. Using Python, you can develop desktop applications, web applications, GUI applications, gaming applications. Not only in IT market, even non-IT industries also widely used scripting is what? Python. NASA, for scientific computations, they are using what? Python scripting. Bioinformatics field, widely used scripting is Python. Pharmaceutical industries, Python. Mathematics and scientific application side, Python. Mechanical engineering side, Python. Robotics side, Python. See, nearly 3000 plus technologies are available in the IT market. Any technology we can use what? Python scripting. So how we can use one scripting language any field in the IT and non-IT industries means with the help of what? Modules only. With the help of what? Modules. Yeah, I will discuss what is a, yeah, 1 minute. Yeah, what is module means? Someone raised the doubt, what is module? See, module is a collection of properties and methods. Someone already developed for us modules. Yourself, no need to sit, no need to write many lines of code. Import the module. I imported some Boto module. This Boto module is used for AWS people. Okay, AWS module is what? Boto. Suppose you are in a AWS site. Okay, so then how to integrate Python in AWS side means, for AWS, what is the library they given? Boto. Import Boto. So module is nothing but collection of properties and methods. So already in this module, they define a number of properties and methods. Then according to your task requirement, you have to call Boto dot EC2 dot connect to is a method to region. Then you have to pass your credentials to which region you want to connect that region name, then access key and a secret access key. You have to pass what parameters here. Now it connects to that region. After once it is connected to region, then you can start your AWS EC2 instance. Okay, all these modules, see here I will show you. See, so let me. So to use Python in web development side, the used framework is what? Django. Django is a web framework. Using Python, if you want create dynamic websites and web applications and all, so you have to learn additionally what? Django framework, or pyramid framework, or Plask framework, bottle frameworks. And using Python, if you want to develop GUI based applications, these are the modules, Kinter, PyQt, WxPython. Using Python, if you want to develop gaming applications, you must use the library called as what? Pygame. Using Python, if you want to use Python in data science or artificial intelligence or machine learning, so the modules are what? These are the modules. These are all data science modules, NumPy, Numeric Python, SciPy, Scientific Python, and Pandas module. Pandas. Okay, Pandas for what? Data visualization, data analytics. To analyze data, use data, how to analysis, how to design data frames, how to find out summarized aggregations data and all, you have to go for Pandas. If you want to analyze data in form of plots, 2D plots, then the module is what? Matplotlib. To do any stats related operations, the module is what? Stats module. For machine learning, the module is what? Scikit module, NLTK module. These two are machine learning modules. If you want to use Python in Hadoop side, the module is PyDoop module. To use in Spark side, the module is PySpark module. To use Python in a DevApp side, Fabric module, or OS module, Sys module, Shuttle module, Subprocess module, Pathlib module. These modules are used for system admin as well as DevOps engineers. For AWS people, Boto module. For data science people, these are the modules. Machine learning, these are the modules. And if you want to use Python for web scraping, I want read data from web pages, URL lib2 and beautiful SU4. These two modules for web scraping. Even for data scientists also, user modules are what? To read data from web pages, I want to see the reviews. Based on reviews, I want to take the course. Suppose I want to go for Python course. So I want to see what? Python reviews. Based on that, I want to join the course. So how to read data from web pages. So how to scrap data from web pages. So user modules are this. If you want to use Python in networking side, the module is what? Socket module. Okay, and a twisted module and a client server module. Like thousands of modules Python has given. Okay, yourself no need to write many lines of code. Just import the module. Okay, every task already they define methods in the module. Import the module, call the method. To call that method, you should know the basic Python. Because all these modules, they developed by using what? Python. All these modules developed by using what? Python. If you know the procedural oriented Python, if you know the object oriented Python, easy to learn what? These modules. Even in my course, I will cover all these modules. Okay. You don't bother about these modules. I will discuss what these modules at end of the course. Even before that, I will discuss how to create our own modules, how to create our own packages, where do you have to register modules, how to import these modules into our Python programs in various ways. So for that reason only, we can use Python any field in the IT as well as what? Non-IT industries. And it is an interactive and dynamic language. And it is extensible in C and C++. Python supports C libraries, C++ libraries, Java libraries. You can write some piece of code in C or CPP or Java. That code you can integrate in where? Python program. And it is very rich in text processing features. That is what? Regular expressions. This is one more very important chapter of what? Python scripting. In any text file to do any manipulations, the regular expressions plays what? Vital role. So these are all some important features of what? Python. Why we have to learn Python? Why we have to go for Python means the three important reasons are Python is very simple and very easy to learn. And second reason is free software and open source software. And third reason is it has very, very rich set of what? Libraries. With help of these libraries, we can use Python anywhere in any of the field. And no need to write many lines of code. Directly they developed what? Modules. Okay, directly they developed what? Modules. Import the modules, call the methods. So in my course also, let's see. So in my course also, here I will cover what? Core Python and Advanced Python. In Core Python, I will discuss some basic syntaxes and variables, data types and all, how to do manipulations in the strings and all operators, input functions, control statements, if statements and looping statements. Then I will discuss Python data structures, are also called as Python collections or Python sequences, like listers, tuples, sets, dictionaries. Then functions, how to create our own functions. So without parameters, with positional, name, default, variable length arguments, return statement, by value and by reference, local, global variables. Then some advanced functions, lambda, map, filter, reduce, iterators, generators, yield statement. Then let's see how to create our own modules. See, Python itself has given 1 lakh plus modules. If you want, you can develop your own modules. You can upload those modules into GitHub also. If they're satisfied with your module, even they can release your module as a new module. So I will discuss how to create our own modules, how to import those modules, where do you have to register the modules, how to set the path, how to create our own packages, how to create a package under what? Sub packages, how to import the packages, how to set the path. Then I will discuss some built-in, some standard modules, how to work with math module, random module, date and time, OS and sys, string module. And one more very important chapter, file handling, how to work with files, how to do manipulations in the files. So till this core Python. Next is advanced Python. Advanced Python means object-oriented Python. How to, what is class, how to create class, private, protected, public, access, specifiers, self-argument, constructors, destructors, inheritance, different types of inheritance, polymorphism, exception handling, how to create user-defined exceptions, multi-threading, and one more important chapter is what? Regular expressions. Then how to communicate with database, how to do transactions in the database. So here I will discuss how to communicate with Oracle database and MySQL database and how to do the transactions. Then these modules, command line arguments, very important who are in a DevOps side, system admin side, AWS side and all. How to make Python file as executable file. And how to work with Excel files, how to do manipulations in Excel files, how to work with CSV files, JSON files, XML modules. So till this point, common for everyone. Okay, now whoever attending the class, so till this point, you should be very, very strong. If you are good in this point, after that, easy to learn what? Modules. These modules at end of the course, I will discuss. So who are in data science side, I will discuss what for those guys, data science modules. Who are in DevOps side, AWS side, those modules. Web scrapping modules, networking people, networking modules. According to where you are working, what is your technology, according to that I will discuss what modules. So here Python you can use in two ways. First I said what? Automation. first purpose is what? Automation. So who are in system admin, database admin, networking side, Hadoop side, DevOps side, data science side, machine learning side, robotic engineering side, animation side. For all these people, Python called a you have to use Python as what? Add-on technology. Okay, you have to use Python as what? Add-on technology. That is for what? Support. And one more area is purely you can work as what? Python developer. Purely you can work as what? Python developer. But to work as a Python developer, we have two types of developers. One is Python web developer. One is Python web developer. So web developer means what are the skills are required means Python. What here I'm teaching that Python. After learning this Python, you have to learn what? Python web framework. Python web framework. Right? So one of the most popular framework is what? Django. But this Django code, the Django web framework is not included in this course. So in this course, I'm not teaching what Django web framework. Only I'm teaching what Python. Who are interested to work as a Python web developers after learning this Python course, what I'm teaching after learning this Python, you have to learn what Django web framework. To learn this Django web framework, the prerequisite is what Python, because this framework developed by using what Python. And definitely require little bit knowledge of what SQL, because you must communicate with what database servers, required knowledge of SQL. So this combination called as Python web developer. If you know, if you are aware of these three skills, then you can apply for what Python web developer. And one more is Python programmer. So to work as a Python programmer means Python plus C. Plus C++. This combination called as what? Python programmer. By learning only Python, you can't work as what? Python programmer. Python with Django combination, or Python with C, C++ combination, or Python with Java combination, or Python with .NET combination. So this profile called as what? Python developers, Python programmers. But who are in automation side, like system admin side, ETL side, reporting side, Hadoop side, data science side, DevOps side, AWS networking, or VLS side, design, embedded system side, or middleware technologies. For all those people, what here I'm teaching, this Python is what? Sufficient. Who are interested to work purely as a Python developers or Python programmers, after learning this Python course, additionally you have to learn what? Either Django web framework or C, C++ or Java or .NET. That combination called as what? Python developer. So right guys?
Yes, madam.
Yeah, so yeah, any challenges, any queries?
Can we able to get soft copy for this lesson?
Yeah, definitely. See, here whatever every day I'm teaching, after the session I will upload what video. And I will upload what notes, whatever notes here I'm showing, that notes I will upload. Yeah, and I will upload what the programs also. I will add
along with the voice, I guess. If you will upload, then it will be good.
Yeah, I will upload.
Means whatever.
Yeah,
every yeah, okay, day, okay. Every day, then yeah. That is fine.
Yeah, every day I will upload. Yeah.
It will be good if you can upload the ISO image for Linux or CentOS, okay. So that we can install Python and
yeah, here I will show you the Python on Windows, Unix and Linux platforms also. Okay, once I start the practicals, I will show you on what Ubuntu operating system.
Okay.
Yes.
So when the real
exactly it will take 30 days.
Yeah, 25 hours, so 30 days.
Okay.
Okay, guys.
So what is the what is the class timing, ma'am?
Yeah, daily 9:30 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. IST timings.
So daily 1 hour.
Daily 1 hour. So daily 9:30 to 10:30 p.m. IST timings. Duration is 25 hours. That means 30 days. And this is WhatsApp number, and this is what office number, and it is my mail ID. If you want, note down this.
So when you gonna start the class?
Yeah, tomorrow itself I will continue the classes.
Oh, Monday, fantastic.
Yeah, Monday to Saturday classes.
Okay.
Okay, guys. So any queries?
Okay.
Oh, timings is okay for all?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. And I will very clearly I will discuss what every day my sessions will be like this only. Very clearly I will discuss what each and every point, for each and every point clear notes you can find, and complete programs. And my course main concept is what more assignments I will give you, because Python is very simple, very easy to learn, but same time need what practice is very important. Here no need to think much logic, but according to task requirement you should know which is the proper method, which is the proper function. Okay, for that need what practice. For that reason, nearly in the total in this course, nearly I will discuss 300 to 400 programs I will discuss. So in the meanwhile, I will discuss some real-time scenarios also.
Okay.
So tomorrow onwards, regular classes, tomorrow at 9:30, same timings. Tomorrow I will discuss how to download the software, how to install the software, how to write one simple script, and how to run in Windows platform as well as Unix or Linux platforms. And I will start data types, variables, different types of strings, the basic syntaxes. These points I will discuss in the tomorrow's class.
Okay.
So just drop your mail ID so I can upload what the video and the notes demo. I copied only the few of the mail IDs. Yeah, Javed, I need your mail ID. And Shri. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, hello. Who is this?
This is Shri. So yeah. I question if I want to develop an Android web app, Android application.
Yeah.
Then
you have to learn after this course. You have to learn the framework.
Okay. Which framework would that be?
Yeah, Django framework.
Okay, so Python and the Django framework. That
yeah.
is all.
Yeah. For that required little bit knowledge of what SQL also.
Okay, so I don't need Java.
Doesn't require.
Okay, all right, thank you.
Yeah.
So ma'am, for myself, I'm looking for big data.
Yeah. So for that also here, I said the library called as PyDoop.
PySpark. PyDoop, okay.
Yeah, Hadoop for PyDoop, and Spark is PySpark.
Okay, but my question is, I want something serious to crack interview level of coding.
Okay. Yeah, that only here I will give you lots of assignments. And do you have any tasks you want to do in your big data side? Means if you tell your task, for that I will give you the code.
Okay. Do you have anything in hand right now?
Yeah, I have some two or three tasks are there, like frequency of words, some code is it.
Like a decent size of code, if you can forward me to my email.
What is your mail ID? Apart the Saridina?
Uh, No, it's Rao, sdrao.lnr.
Okay. Yeah, I will copy.
I'm sending you again.
Yeah, yeah. I copied.
That's the one.
Yeah. Yeah. So definitely I will check that code. If it is there, I will forward to your mail account.
Yes, please. Send me a decent size one. So I want to practice that and see. I'm happy to join the course.
Yeah. I think after attending like a 2 weeks of session, if I send that code, you can understand. Because you are new to Python, no?
I'm new to Python, but I did have a bit of knowledge about executing the code and the outcomes.
Okay.
Well, now I have to give a kind of demonstration here. So I'm looking for something which I can break it down step by step.
Okay. Just you send one or two tasks. According to that, I will forward the code.
All right. Yeah. Right. I'll do that.
Yeah. Okay.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, hi. Who is it?
Hello, ma'am. Yeah, Sairam here.
Yeah, Sairam. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm basically like a Selenium with Java testing tester.
Yep.
So can I roll up the scripts in the Python by using Selenium?
Yeah, you can develop. So for that, some library is there. I'm not remember at present that library name. Using that library, you can develop.
This course is enough, or can I want to learn any other?
You know, sir, this course is sufficient. No need to learn anything. Actually, why we have to learn this course means, now you said Selenium with Java.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So whatever task there you are doing in Python, we have library, is it? Okay, we can import that library. In the library itself, already they define all the methods. Whatever tasks you are doing, like Selenium with Java, all those tasks, all those tasks already they developed what methods in the module.
Okay.
Okay, we have to import the module.
In Selenium, I'm using Eclipse. I'm importing the jars and there only. In Python, how can I write in like is I'm writing a code in the Eclipse or any other thing is there in the Python?
You can write
in
Eclipse. You can write PyCharm. You can write Jupyter. You can write Spider. You can write.
Okay.
In Eclipse also, you can write the Python scripts.
Okay.
The best editor is PyCharm. Okay. Or Jupyter, or Autumn, Sublime. So many editors are available.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, welcome.